I welcome you all to the new session of the complex integral. In this complex integration, today we shall be discussing about the Cauchy integral theorem. So Cauchy integral theorem is very, very important in solving the complex integrals, where we shall be given a contour or a region in which the integral has to be integrated, and over that integral, over that region or over that contour, we shall see that whether there is any singularity or not, and if the singularity is residing inside or it is residing outside that region. So if the singularity is residing outside the region that is defined to us, so we can directly say that the integral of our function over dz will be equal to zero. So this important Cauchy integral theorem is very, very important to calculate the integral, where just by looking at the function and the space specified, we can directly predict the value of our integrals. So let us look at the statement of the Cauchy integral theorem. So the statement goes here as, if the integral fz is analytic. So we have already discussed in the previous modules, what do you mean by the analyticity of the function? So analyticity means that we say that the function is derivable and continuous within a particular region, and the CR equations are also satisfied. And if the CR equations are satisfied, then we can find the differential of our function. So if a function is defined, is analytic, and the derivative is also continuous at all the points inside a simple closed curve C. So here we have given a simple closed curve C. It could be a shape of a circle, a rectangle, a circle, or a square. So it could be any arbitrary closed curve. And what we are saying that the function is analytic at each and every point inside this region C. So it is analytic at all the points in region C, means it is not infinite, it is not giving us infinite value, it is derivable, it is continuous in this whole region. So if there is such type of a function which is derivable, it is continuous in this closed, simple closed curve, then we can directly say that the integral of this function over this region will be equal to zero. So let us see at the proof of this statement. So we have that we have a R region enclosed by the curve C. So this is the R region that is enclosed by our curve C. And always remember that the contour of the, that is the way in which the circle will be moving, the path along which the circle is moving is taken in the anti-clockwise direction. So we are saying that the R is a region enclosed by the curve C, and the function is given to be as fz, which is represented by u plus iota v, which is also represented by w. So z is equal to x plus iota y, and dz is dx plus iota dy. So we substitute the values of fz and dz in the integral. So we have integral fz dz, which can be written as u plus iota v into dx plus iota dy. So we have the real and imaginary parts. We multiply the two terms. We get the real part to be u dx minus v dy plus iota integral v dx plus u dy. We have already studied in our previous classes about the Green's theorem, where the Green's theorem relate the line integral into the surface integral. So by using the Green's theorem, we can relate our line integral to the surface integral by the formula that line integral over C m dx plus n dy is equal to surface integral over R del n by del x minus del m by del y into dx dy. So using this Green property, we substitute the values of the integral. So we replace our first integral by using the Green's theorem as minus del v by del x minus del u by del x dx dy. So you can see here what happened, that the line integral is now changed into the surface integral, or we can say it has changed into the double integral. And the integral is over the dx dy. Similarly, for the second integral, we have applied the Green's theorem. So we get here the term as del u by del x minus del v by del y into dx dy. And similarly, the line integral is changed to the surface integral. So we know that we have these Cauchy-Riemann equations, because the function was given to be the analytic function, such that del u by del x is del v by del y, and del u by del y is minus del v by del x. So we substitute this equation. So for del v by del x, we have writing here as del u by del y. So both these del u by del y gets cancelled. And similarly here, del v by del y substituted to be del u by del x, such that this del u by del x also gets cancelled because the function was analytic function. So what we get that our integral fz dz is equal to zero, which was the statement of the Cauchy integral theorem. So far, the function is analytic and its derivative is continuous at all the points inside and on a simple closed curve. Then the function integral over C fz dz will be equal to zero. But always remember that no pole, no singularity should be lying inside or on the contour of the core. Even the singularity should not lie on this contour. It should not lie on the path that is followed by the contour, or it should not lie inside. The singularity or the pole point should lie just outside this. Then only the statement is valid. Otherwise, we cannot apply the Cauchy integral theorem. If the singularity is lying inside the circle or inside the closed curve, then we shall be applying the Cauchy integral formula, which we shall be discussing in the successive modules. So this is there, that no pole should be lying inside or on the contour of the curve, then the value of the integral of fz is zero. So let us look at the question related to the Cauchy integral theorem. So we are given here that we have to find the integral over C 1 upon z minus a dz. So this is our function. So first of all, what we shall be finding, the singularity or the poles. And we are given that it is a simple closed curve. C is a simple closed curve, and the singularity, that is z, is equal to A, is lying outside C. So how to find out the singularity or the poles? So singularity is found out by substituting the denominator equal to zero. So if we substitute the denominator, so we have in the denominator as z minus A. So when we substitute our denominator, z minus A equal to zero, we get the singularity point, that is z is equal to A. And it is already specified in the question that this z is equal to A is lying outside the circle. So if we have this circle, the z is equal to A point is lying outside the circle. And since it is lying outside the circle, so what we can apply, this Cauchy integral theorem, and we can directly use this Cauchy integral theorem to write our value of the expression, that integral over C 1 upon z minus a dz is equal to 0. So applying this theorem, we can directly substitute our result to be equal to 0. We need not find the value of the integral, and we will have the result. Let's look at another problem of Cauchy integral theorem. So we have the question here that the integral is over C z square minus z plus 1 upon z minus 1 dz, where C is a simple closed curve given to be the equation of the circle, that is modulus z equal to 2 is the given equation of circle. So this equation of circle means that center point is at 0, because we know that the equation is z minus a equals to r. So this half value is the radius of the circle, and since it's only z, it means that it is z minus 0. So the center point of the circle is at the origin 0. So we draw a circle. You can see here we have drawn a circle with the center at point 0, and the radius is all half at all the four axes. So the radius is half along the all the axes. So you can see here it is half 0, it will be 0 half, it will be minus half 0, and it will be 0 minus half. So here we substitute, first of all, what we have to see, we have to just equate the denominator equal to 0 to find the pole points. So the pole is obtained by equating the denominator. So we have from the denominator z minus 1 equal to 0, which gives our pole to be equal to z equal to 1. So now we have to locate our pole point in this circle. So what we see that here the circle is having a radius of half. So this z is equal to one pole point will be lying outside the circle of radius half. So here it is the pole point. And since it is lying outside the circle, it does not include any singularity. So using the Cauchy integral theorem, we will directly substitute our result to be equal to that. The integral z square minus z plus 1 upon z minus 1 dz will be equal to 0. It doesn't matter whatever is the function in the numerator. If the pole point is residing outside the region specified, then directly we will substitute that the integral fz dz will be equal to 0. Looking at the next problem, so we have to find the integral, that is integral over c 5z square plus 9 upon z plus 3 ka whole cube into z square plus 4 dz. Here the contour is given to be a square which is having the vertices 1 plus iota, 2 plus iota, 2 plus 2 iota and 1 plus 2 iota. So let us first plot the square. So for 1 plus iota, we will have the coordinates to be equal to 1, 1. For 2 plus iota, the coordinates will be 2, 1. For 2 plus 2 iota, we will have the coordinates to be 2, 2. And for 1 plus 2 iota, we will have the coordinate as 1, 2. So we have the vertices of the square, we join these vertices. So what we get a contour to be a square. So next point will be to find the pole point. So for finding the pole point, I put this denominator to be equal to 0. So when I put the denominator to be equal to 0, for z plus 3 ka whole cube, I get the value of z to be equal to, z is equal to minus 3. And since here I have a power of 3, so for 3 power, what I will have that my pole will be of order 3. When I put my z square plus 4 equal to 0, I get my z to be equal to plus minus of 2 iota. Since they are two different values of z, so it is not repeating itself. So for non-repeated values of z, for non-repeated singularities, we call it as a simple pole. So these are, we have three values of z, which is plus 2 iota, minus 2 iota, which is a simple pole. And since minus 3 is repeated 3 times, so it is called the pole of order 3. So I will check that whether any of these pole points are residing inside the contour of the square. So when I will substitute the value of minus 3, I find that this z equal to minus 3 will be lying on some negative axis of x. So if I extrapolate my negative axis, I find that I can put the z equal to minus 3 on the negative axis, which is again residing out of the square. And for 2 iota means it is lying on the plus y axis. So 2 iota is again here on the positive y axis, and minus 2 iota will be on the minus, on the negative y axis. The points are not up to scale. So I have fitted my pole points, and I can see here that these pole points are not lying inside the contour of the square. So since it is not lying on the contour or inside the contour, that is the square, so I can directly use the Cauchy integral theorem. So all the obtained pole lies outside the contour C. So by Cauchy integral theorem, I will directly substitute that the integral fz dz is equal to 0. So by this integral value is equal to 0. I will not have to calculate or solve the integral directly. I will be substituting my result to be equal to 0. So before moving further, let us have a quick insight about the simply connected region and the multiply connected region. So what do you mean by simply connected region? Simply connected region means it is a simple closed curve. So here, if we draw a curve C, closed curve C, and there is a region D, and if we say that if the interior points of the closed curve C drawn in the region D are the points of region D, so then that region or that is called as the simply connected region. So this means that this is a simple closed curve and we have certain points in our region which was enclosed by the curve C. So this curve does not cross each other. So but the multiply connected region, what is that? That we will have more than one curve. So it is bounded by more than one curve. We can have two curves, three curves in that region. So we shall be converting our multi-connected region into simply connected region by introducing the cuts. So you can see here that this is a multi-connected region. You can say this as a multi-connected region where we have two curves, two closed curves. And if here it was like this, if we could join all these circles, so we will have that in a bigger circle is including four smaller circles. So then it will be called as the multi-connected region. So how to convert a multi-connected region into a simply connected region is just by introducing a cut. So if we introduce a cut here, so what happens that it is open from this end and it is open from this end. So if we move it, so we know that the always the outer curve or the outer boundary of the circle or any contour is to be anti-clockwise direction. So we are moving in this anti-clockwise direction. So when we come at this point of the cut, so at this point we have to move inside the cut and then we shall be moving in the clockwise direction and then we shall be coming out of the other end of the cut and then again rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. So you can see here by just introducing this cut, we have now moved our multi-connected region into simply connected region so that if we open up this curve, what we will get? We will get a simple closed curve. Similarly, if we had a circle which was enclosing four smaller circles and we introduced four cuts here, you can see here we have introduced four cuts. So when we introduce four cuts, always remember that the outside periphery of the circle should be in the anti-clockwise direction. So when you move, we have on the cuts, we have that the our inside circle's boundary would be traced in the clockwise direction. So you can see here that all the inner circles are traced in the clockwise direction, whereas the outside periphery of the circle is traced in the anti-clockwise direction. So in this way, if you open up this, what happens that this region is all discarded and the region enclosed by this curve is just this inner circle, inner part of this value, and this is a continuous region. So in this way, by introducing the cuts, we can convert the multi-connected region into simply connected regions. So using these definitions of the multi-connected regions, simply connected regions, we shall be extending our result of the Cauchy integral theorem to Cauchy integral theorem to multi-connected regions, or we shall be also having the results of the Cauchy integral formulas. So let us look at the extension of the Cauchy integral theorem. So the statement of the extension of the Cauchy integral theorem to the multi-connected region states that if the function is analytic in the region R between two simple closed curves. So if we have two simple closed, this is one closed curve and this is one closed curve, and the region in which the function is analytic is in this region. This is the region between the two simple closed curves. So if it is analytic in the region between the two simple closed curves C1 and C2, then we can say that the integral over the outer boundary over C1 fz dz will be equal to the integral C2 fz dz. Means that the integral over this region will be, this boundary will be equal to the integral over the inner boundary. So if we have two simple closed curves, then we have the formula that integral over C1 fz dz is equal to integral C2 fz dz. But if we have one big curve is inclusive of three smaller or four smaller curves, then we can say that the outer integral over the outer curve will be equal to the sum of these smaller curves. So it will be integral over C fz dz will be equal to integral over C2 fz dz plus integral over C3 fz dz plus integral over C4 fz dz. Have the proof of this extension theorem. So let us see at the proof. Now we know from the Cauchy integral theorem that the integral fz dz over the curve C is equal to 0. Now we have two curves. We have introduced a cut between our two simple closed curves so that we can convert the multi-connected region into a simply connected region. And the region enclosed between the two curves, there the function fz is analytic. So in this shaded portion, the function is analytic, because by introducing the cut, you exclude certain portion for which the function would not be analytic. So the path of the integration, you can see, always remember that outside periphery, we take the direction to be anticlockwise. So when we shall move along the cut, so here we will find that it will move along AB inside, then it will move in the clockwise direction along the C2, and then it will move outside, and then again it will follow the same anticlockwise path. So we have this. So now for this integral, we break up our integral into four parts. So we write it over integral over AB. Then since it is C2, it is in the clockwise direction. So we take a negative value, because for the anticlockwise, we assume to be the positive sign, and for the clockwise, we assume it to be of the negative sign. So we have the integral over AB, then we have a negative sign associated with the clockwise direction over C2, we have over BA, and then it is over the C1 curve, which is in the anticlockwise direction taken as a positive sign. So all these integral is equal to zero. So we know that when we are integrating over this line integral over AB, in one of the path we are going inside and in one path we are going outside. So the numerical value will be same, but there will be only a sign difference. I mean, over one way it will have a positive sign, and on the other way it will have a negative sign. So the integral over AB will be equal to BA. So if we substitute the result of integral over AB and BA, it will cancel each other, and such that we will be left out with two parts of the integral, that is integral over C2 and integral over C1. So we have already substituted that for the C2, it is taking a negative sign, and for C1, it is taking the positive sign. So when we rearrange our terms, what we get? We get that the integral over C1 fz dz will be equal to integral over C2 fz dz. And we can extend it over many more curves, where we have seen that this C1 curve is bounded by three or four more curves. So we can extend our relation that integral over C1 fz dz is equal to integral over C2 fz dz plus integral over C3 fz dz plus integral over C4 fz dz. So this is the statement of the Cauchy integral theorem extension to the multi-connected regions. So I hope that you have understood the concept of simply connected, multi-connected, and you know how to apply the Cauchy integral theorem also. So thank you, and meet you again. Thank you.